and welcome to Virtual Learning Network Online Classes. Subject MS09 Managerial Economics. Block 3 Production and Cost Analysis 1. Include Laffer curve. A woman hears from her doctor that she has only half a year to live. The doctor advises her to marry an economist and to move to South Dakota. Will this curb my illness? She asked. No, but the half year will seem pretty long. Now, introduction of this block. In the supply process, people first offer their factors of production to the market. As you know that, in supply process, sellers is focused on the prices as well as the delivery of the goods to the consumers. Then the factors are transformed by form into goods that consumers want. And our production. Production is the name given to that transformation of factors into goods. Or in other words, we can say that production means input plus process equal to output. Production is a process by which we get the goods as consumable stage, also known as production. So there is many definitions of the production. Now the role of firm. The firm is an economic institutions that transforms factors of production into consumer goods. It organizes factors of production, produces goods and services, and sales produced goods and services. So we can say that there are three activities run by the firm. The very first is organizing the production system, then production both of goods and services that is required by the consumer in a particular economy, and then distributions of the goods as per requirement to the consumer. This is the production. Role of firm. A virtual firm only organizes production. Virtual firm subcontract out all work. More and more of the organization structure of business is being separated from the business. The firm and the market. Firm operate within the market because market is a place where the firm can sell their product, while at the same time firm replaces the market with command and control. How an economy operates depends on transaction cost. Cost of undertaking trades through the market and the rent or command over resources that organizers can appropriate to themselves by organizing the market in a certain way. Firms are the production organizations that translate factors of production into consumer goods. Or in other words, we can say that firm is a system in which the goods translate from one form to another. And the objectives of the firms, the very first objective of firms is to earn maximum profit. As you know, profit is the difference between total revenue and total cost. Symbolically, it can be shown as profit equal to total revenue minus total cost. Economists and accountants measure profit differently. Accountants focus on explicit cost and revenue, whereas economists focus on both explicit and implicit cost and revenue. Explicit cost is actually the actual cost that is earned by the organization in a certain period of time, and revenue means total sales revenue or total amount that is earned by the organization in a certain period of time. For an economist, total cost is explicit payment to factors of production plus the opportunity cost of the factors provided by the owners of the firm. Opportunity cost I have already explained in block second. Opportunity cost is a sacrificing cost which is get or which is suffered by the individual or organization to get another opportunities. Economists define total revenue as the amount a firm receives for selling its goods or services plus any increase in the value of assets owned by firm. For economists, economic profit equal to explicit and implicit revenue minus explicit and implicit cost equal to economic profit. The production process can be divided into the long run and short run, and these are the period. Short run period means a period of less than 1 year, whereas long run a period of more than 1 year. A long run decision is a decision in which the firm can choose among all possible production techniques, whereas a short term decision is one in which the firm is constrained in regard to what production decisions it can make. The long run and short run. The terms long run and short run do not necessarily refer to a specific period of time. They refer to the degree of flexibility the firm has in changing the level of output in economics. In the long run, all inputs are variable, and in short term, some inputs are variable and others are fixed. Production tables and production function. A production table shows the output resulting from various combination of factors of productions or inputs. In other words, we can say that production table is a table in which we have determined the values or appear the value, different values like fixed cost, variable cost, average cost, marginal cost, and so on. Production table or under production table, we have calculated the marginal product. Marginal product is the additional output that will be forthcoming from an additional worker, other inputs remaining constant. In other words, we can say that marginal product is a additional product produced by same workers apart from existing productions. Suppose a worker produce 1000 units in 8 hours working, but any day he or she has produced 105 units in same time, then the additional 5 unit is called marginal product. Average product is a calculated by dividing total output by the quantity of the output. And symbolically, we can say that total product divided by total quantity. Production function, a curve that describes the relationship between the inputs and output or factor of production is called production function. As functions refers as the relationship between two variables, like production function is a variables of raw material, wages, and other factors of production. The production function tells the maximum amount of output that can be derived from a given number of inputs. Now, a production table. you can calculate that different values into the production table. Suppose number of workers in a factory at level 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When one worker is worked, then he or she produced 4 units of output at a certain period of time. Whenever 2 is engaged, then 10 units produce. Then 3 workers is engaged, 17 produce. Then 4 engaged, 23 is produce. 5, 28, 6, 31, 7, 32, 8, 32, 9, 30, and 10, 25. And now we can calculate the marginal product from this table. For calculating marginal product, one worker produced only 4 units, then another worker is introduced, then the production is 10, which is 10 minus 4 equal to 6 is additional unit produced by one worker added into the production process, then 17 minus 10, 7, then 23 minus 17, 6, 28 minus 23, 5, 31 minus 28, 3, 32 minus 31, 1, 32 minus 32, 0, 30 minus 32, minus 2, and 25 minus 30, minus 5. This is the marginal product. Then average product can be calculated as 4 divided by 4, the 4 divided by 1 equal to 4, 10 divided by 2 equal to 5, 17 divided by 2, 3, 5.7, 23 divided by 4, 5.8, 28 divided by 5, 5.6, 31 divided by 6, 5.2, 32 divided by 7, 4.6, 32 divided by 8 equal to 4, then 30 divided by 9, 3.3, and after that 25 divided by 10, which is equal to 2.5. As given in this table, you can calculate the value of marginal product and average product by the number of workers with the total output. And now this is the production function or production curve. In x-axis, you have seen number of workers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 as per the example given above. And the total production starting from level 0 to 32. Then when one worker worked, then the unit produced by him or her is 4. And we plot a point in front of 4 with the 1. Then if 2 workers is engaged, then both of these produce 10 items. So we plot a point in front of 10. Then whenever 3 workers is engaged, they produce 14 units, 4 18 units, 5 22, 6 28, 7 28, 8 30, and 9 less than 32, and then 10, and a line is drawn to intersect all the point is called TP, that means total product. Same as we can show the curve of marginal product as well as average product with the table given in previous slide. So this is the marginal product and this is the average product. As you have seen that marginal product is greater or less than that of the average product. Marginal product becomes zero at any level and will be negative, whereas average product cannot be negative, but it is in declining stage. Law of diminishing marginal productivity. Both marginal and average productivity initially increases, but eventually they both decreases. Now the law of diminishing marginal productivity or diminishing marginal utility. This means that initially the production functions exhibit increasing marginal productivity, then it exhibits diminishing marginal productivity. Finally, it exhibits negative marginal productivity. The most relevant part of the production function is that part exhibiting diminishing marginal productivity. The law of diminishing marginal productivity, law of diminishing marginal productivity, as more and more of a variable input is added to an existing fixed input, after some point the additional output one gets from the additional input will fall, as you have seen in previous slide. Now, law of diminishing marginal utility, same table is given here as given in previous, and this is the diagram of production curve that shows the diminishing and marginal productivity. As you have seen in total product table or curve, increasing marginal return is gone up to this point. After that, it became diminish to a point of time, that is the constant return, and then it will be fall down. Same as if we think about the marginal product and average product, both is increasing in a certain level and after that diminishing marginal return should be get by us. This law is also called the Fuller's pot law. If it did not hold true, the world's entire food supply could be grown in a single flower pots. The cost of production. There are many different types of costs. Invariably, firms believe costs are too high and try to lower them to get the ultimate objective of the firm, which is to earn maximum profit. Now, fixed costs. Fixed costs are those that are spent and cannot be changed in the period of time under consideration. In other words, we can say that fixed cost is a cost which cannot be changed due to the change of production. In the long run, there are no fixed costs since all costs are variable. In the short run, a number of costs will be fixed. Workers represent variable costs, those that changes as output changes. The sum of the variable and fixed costs are total cost. And symbolically, we can say that TC equal to FC plus VC. TC stand for total cost, FC stand for fixed cost, and VC stand for variable cost. Now, average cost. Much of the firm's discussion is of average cost. Average cost means total cost divided by number of unit produced. So average total cost, often called average cost, equal total cost divided by the quantity produced. It can be determined as average total cost equal to total cost divided by quantity. Average fixed cost equal fixed cost divided by quantity produced. AFC equal to fixed cost divided by quantity. And now average cost or average variable cost equal to variable cost divided by quantity produced. That means ABC equal to VC upon Q. That means variable cost divided by quantity produced by the organization in a certain period of time. Average total cost can also be thought of as the sum of average fixed cost and average variable cost. So ATC equal to AFC plus ABC. Marginal cost. Marginal cost is the increase or decrease in total cost of increasing or decreasing the level of output by one unit. Whenever one unit is increased into the production, then what amount of cost is increased is called marginal cost. In deciding how many units to produce, the most important variable is marginal cost. Graphing cost curves. The gain is greater understanding of these concepts. It is a good idea to draw a graph. Quantity is put on the horizontal axis, a dollar, measure of various cost on the vertical axis. The total variable cost curve has the same shape as the total cost curve, increasing output and increasing variable cost. Total cost curve, this is a TF TB or TC equal to VC plus FC. It is a, then TC is greater than this one stays. Average and marginal cost curve. The marginal cost curve goes through the minimum point of average total cost curve and average variable cost curve. Each of these curves is U-shaped. The average fixed cost curve slopes down continuously. Downward sloping shape of average fixed cost curve. The average fixed cost curve looks like a child's slide. It starts out with a steep decline, then it becomes flatter and flatter. It tells us that as output increases, the same fixed cost can be spread out over a wider range of output. Therefore, the per unit cost, fixed cost should be declined. When output is increased in the short run, it can only be done by increasing the variable input. The law of diminishing marginal productivity sets in as more and more of variable input is added to a fixed input. Marginal and average productivity falls and marginal cost raise. And when average productivity of the variable input falls, average variable cost raise. The average total cost curve is the vertical summation of the average fixed cost curve and the average variable cost curve. If the firm increased output enormously, the average variable cost curve and the average total cost curve would almost meet. The firm size is focused on average total cost. It want to keep it low. Relationship between productivity and cost. The shape of cost curves are mirror image reflections of the shape of the corresponding productivity curves. Relationship between productivity and cost. When one is increasing, the other is decreasing. When one is at a maximum, the other is at a minimum. The marginal cost and average cost curve are related. When marginal cost exceeds average cost must be raising. When marginal cost is less, then average cost must be falling. Marginal cost curves always intersect average cost curve at the minimum of the average cost curve. The positions of the marginal cost relative to average total cost tells us whether average total cost is raising or falling. To summarizing, if MC greater than ATC, then ATC is raising. If MC or marginal cost equal to average total cost, then average total cost is at its low point. When marginal cost less than average total cost, then average total cost is falling. Marginal and average total cost reflect a general relationship that also holds for marginal cost and average variable cost. If marginal cost greater than average variable cost, then average variable cost is raising. If marginal cost equal to average variable cost, then average variable cost is at its low point. And if marginal cost less than average variable cost, then average variable cost is falling. It is a relation between marginal cost and average variable cost. As long as average variable cost does not raise by more than average fixed cost falls, average total cost will fall when marginal cost is above average variable cost. Like this one, this is the relations between cost structures. As you have seen that marginal cost starting from point 1 to the areas of B and area C, this is the marginal cost, and a line green shade is average variable cost and then black is average total cost. And you have seen that average variable cost intersect the marginal cost at below the line of average total cost, and this is the area of fixed cost. because you know that average total cost equal to average variable cost plus average fixed cost. So it is the area of average fixed cost. Now production and cost analysis second. Laffer economists have forecasted 9 out of the last 15 recessions, making long run production decision. To make their long run decision, firm look at cost of various inputs and the techniques or technologies available for combining these inputs. Then decide which combination offers the lowest cost. Making long run production decision, the firm makes long run decisions on the basis of expected cost and expected usefulness of input. Technical efficiency and economic efficiency. Technical efficiency, as few inputs as possible are used to produce a given output. Technical efficiency is efficiency that does not consider cost of input. In other words, we can say that technical efficiency means whenever the input output increases due to the technical or due to the technology introduced for the production process, it is called technical efficiency. Economically efficient, the methods that produces a given level of output at the lowest possible cost, it is the least cost technically efficient process. Determinants of shape of long run cost curve. The law of diminishing marginal productivity does not hold in the long run. All inputs are variable in long run. Determinants of the shape of long run cost curve. The shape of long run cost curve is due to the existence of economies and diseconomies of scales. A typical long run average total cost curve. Quantity produced 11 to 20 and total cost of labor 381, 390, 402 and so on. Then total cost of machine 254. If we want to determine total cost, then total labor cost plus total machine cost equal to 635, 650, 670, and we can also calculate the average total cost like TC divided by Q. That means 635 divided by 11, 650 divided by 12, 670 divided by 13 will get 52, 700 divided by 14 will get 50 and so on. And this is the curve. Now economies of scale. Economies of scale, long run average total cost decreases as output increases. In real world production process, economies of scale are extremely important at low level of production. And individual setup cost is the cost of an individual input for which a certain minimum amount of production must be undertaken before the input become economically feasible to use. Individual setup cost create many real world economies of the scale. The cost of blast furnace or an oil refinery is an example of an individual setup cost. In the longer run, all inputs are variable, so only economies of scale can influence the shape of the long run cost curve. Because of the importance of economies of scale, business people often talk of a minimum efficient level of production. The minimum efficient level of production is the amount of production that spread setup cost out sufficiently for firms to undertake production profitable. The minimum efficient level of production is reached once the size of the market expands to a size large enough so that firm can take advantages of all economies of the scale. This economies of scale. Diminishing marginal productivity refers to the decline in productivity caused by increasing units of a variable input being added to a fixed input. Diseconomy of scale refers to decrease in productivity which occur when there are equal increases of all inputs or no input is fixed. Diseconomies of scale occurs on the right side of the long run average cost curve where it is upward sloping, meaning that average cost is increasing. As the size of the firm increases, monitoring cost generally increases, monitoring costs are those incurred by the organizer of production and seeing to it that the employees do not do what they are supposed to do. As the size of the firm increases, team spirit or morale generally decreases. Team spirit is the feeling of friendship and being part of a team that brings out people's best effort. Constant return to scale. Constant return to scale is where long-run average total cost do not change as output increases. It is shown by the flat portions of the LRATC curve on long-run average total cost curve. And this is the various stages of the production. As we have seen, economies of scale is left side. Constant return to scale or a stage where there is no change of the production due to the change of input, and diminishing or diseconomy of the scale whenever you have add more and more variables to get least output. Economies and diseconomies of scale play important role in real world long run production decision. The long run and the short run average cost curve have the same U shape, but the underlying causes of these shape differ. Economies and diseconomies of scale accounts for the shape of the long run total cost curve. Importance of economies and diseconomies of scale: initially increasing and then eventually diminishing marginal productivity as a variable input is added to a fixed input accounts for the shape of the short run cost curve. Envelope relationship: in the long run, all inputs are flexible, while in the short run, some inputs are not flexible. As a result, long run cost will always be less than or equal to short run cost, but never it is higher. In the short run, the firm faces an additional constraint: all expansion must proceed using only the variable input. These additional constraint increase costs. The envelope relationship explains that at the planned output level, short run average total cost equal long run average total cost. At all other levels of output, short run average total cost is higher than long run average total cost. And this is the curve to show the envelope relationship. SRMC1, that means short run marginal cost 1, is here. Then after introducing another period or quantity, SRMC2, then SRMC3, then SRMC4, and then SRATC1, that means short run average total cost, is here, and SRMC2, then here SRATC2, that means short run average total cost, then SRATC3, that means short run average total cost, then SRATC4, and last one is long run average total cost, which is equal to the all short run cost. Profit is what underlies the dynamic of production in a market economy. The expected price must exceed the opportunity cost of supplying the good for a good to be supplied. Suppliers' expected economy profit per unit, the difference between the expected price of goods and the expected average total cost of producing it. Entrepreneur activity and supply decision. An entrepreneur is an individual who see an opportunity to sell an item at a price higher than the average cost of producing it. As you know that every entrepreneur or every seller want to sell the goods at higher price. So always he or she is expect to get the opportunity whenever the price is high. Entrepreneurial activity and the supply decision. Entrepreneurs organize production, they visualize the demand and convince the individuals who owns the factors of production that they want to produce those goods. Using cost analysis in the real world, Some of the problems of using cost analysis in the real world include the following: economies of scope, learning by doing and technological change, many dimensions, unmeasured cost. Economies of scope, the cost of production of one product often depend on what other products a firm is producing. There are economies of scope when the cost of producing goods are interdependent, so that it is less costly for a firm to produce one good when it is already producing another. Firms look for both economies of scope and economies of scale. Economies of scope play an important role in firms' decision of what combination of goods to be produced, by which the firm can get more profit. Globalization has made economies of scope even more important to firms in their production decision. Learning by doing and technological change, production techniques available to real-world firms are constantly changing because of learning by doing and technical change. These changes occur over time and cannot be accurately predicted. Learning by doing means that as we do something, we learn what works and doesn't, and over time we become more proficient at it. That means whenever we do the things once a life or once a time, then definitely we have lot of time. Then if we are doing continuously a same process or same work, then we reduce the total time that is incurred to doing the things. That is called learning by doing. Many firms estimate workers' productivity to grow 1-2% a year because of learning by doing. Technological change is an increase in the range of production techniques that provides new ways to producing goods. Technological change can fundamentally alter the nature of production cost. Technological change occur in all industries, not only high-tech industries. In many businesses, the effect of learning by doing and technological change on prices is built into the firm's pricing structure. Technological change and learning by doing are intricately related. Most decisions that firm make involve more than one dimension. The only dimension in the standard model is the level of output. Good economic decisions take all relevant marginal cost and benefits into account. The important things to remember in using the standard model is the reasoning, not the specific model. The relevant cost as defined by the economist are not the cost found in the firm's book. Economists include opportunity cost, while accountant use explicit cost that can be measured as opportunity cost or relevant cost. Economists insist on including the business owner's opportunity cost. The business owner's opportunity cost includes foregone income that the owner could have earned by spending his or her time in another job. Economic versus accounting depreciation. Economic depreciation differs from accounting depreciation. In measuring the cost of depreciable assets, accountant insists on using historical cost. What are depreciable items cost in terms of money actually spent for it as the cost basis? If the depreciable assets increased in value, accountant would still use the historical cost basis, while an economist would count its increased value as revenue. Now, the standard model as a framework. Despite its limitation, the standard model provides a good framework for cost analysis. It can be expanded to include real world complication. And thank you for studying block number 3 of MS 9.